Welcome to Module 2 of the RGA Gateway Conference Solution video tutorial. This module covers how to program the SV8100. We'll go to the memory block 10 and set settings 1, 3, and 4 to the values provided by the local site. In addition, you will set 1209 and 1210. Then enable the 6300 licenses for the slot that the RGA card will be installed into. You can apply up to 32 of license code 6300. Then, whether or not you're using the conference functionality, you must set the IP address for the WAN port in 1055.01. This address should be obtained from the local network administrator, as well as a subnet mask and default gateway, which are 5504 and 5505 respectively. Now you're ready to insert the RGA blade into the system. On boot up, the system will recognize the blade, assign the ports, and extension numbers. If you're using PC Pro to perform a database download, or you can use Web Pro to continue programming the SV8100. The next step is establish a department group with a pilot for the RGA conference extensions. This is done in memory block 11701. In this example, we're going to use department group 3. As always, never use department group 1 since this is the default group for all extensions. Then we're going to jump to 150303. And set all the RGA conference extensions to 1, which is special. This is required because the access code is DTMF, which is sent after answer, and on an extension to extension call, this feature has to be there. Now, in 150701, you need to assign at least one cap key to every RGA port. This is to enable the 31-pound dial-out feature of the RGA conferencing. Now, in 160201, you're going to put all the RGA conference extensions that you have in Department Group 3 and then set the priority for each extension. This concludes Module 2.